Let's stay at high noon on the Fox Network. It is Notre Dame. It is Wisconsin.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome to the Cone Zone, Dan.
Yeah.
Welcome to Coney Island. Welcome to Silicon Valley. To a neutral site battle right here in your backyard, Soldier Field. Wisconsin right now is favored by 5.5. I cannot begin to imagine what Gus Johnson is going to do with this Jack Coan storyline come Saturday. I cannot imagine what he's going to do. Did you hear the clip of when Minnesota missed the game-winning field goal against the Cardinals this past Sunday?
Minnesota. Oh, you're talking about the NFL?
Yeah. Did you hear
Gus? I'm trying to connect like Minnesota-Louisville? What? I missed it. No, I didn't see it.
It's almost like Gus had an out-of-body experience.
Was he happy
or
sad?
I'm seriously worried about him. No, I mean, just very emotional.
Okay.
Neither happy nor sad. The guy knows how to emote. He's going to have a field day with the Jack Coan storyline. Jack Coan, of course, transferred over from Wisconsin. He's now starting quarterback for Notre Dame. I am desperate for a Lara Quinn situation. Someone in the crowd with a half Wisconsin, half Notre Dame Jack Coan jersey.
I assume, yeah, we'll get a family. Well, I don't know. Wouldn't a family member potentially feel that Wisconsin did him dirty a little bit?
Don't know. Don't know.
Yeah.
Don't know what the Coan family feels like, what the Coan heads are like right now. Looking out at his former team, but he's going to have an opportunity.
What's your read on the matchup? Because you've watched Notre Dame closer than I have. They've had close calls, single digit situations near the end of both Toledo and Purdue, and now Florida State is sort of along with those two schools in terms of maybe shouldn't have single digit situations at the end, but it was at Florida State opening week, whatever. And they were actually up. That wasn't like a close the entire time. They're up like 18 relatively late, and Florida State came back. You are down on elements of Notre Dame, and
I am.
I presume down on elements of Wisconsin as well, because you watch them against your other team, Penn State. So what hangs in the balance here between these two teams when either team has the ball?
Yeah, and again, going back to what I said at the top, we love to look at advanced stats.
Mm-hmm.
You almost can't go on all the advanced stats here. I'm going to go on something of the eye test because I've watched all of Notre Dame's games, and I did see Wisconsin, Penn State. I've seen plenty of Wisconsin as well.
Right.
So I think the main thing for me is that there is a real genuine mismatch between Wisconsin's defensive line and Notre Dame's offensive line in its current state. This isn't really any kind of groundbreaking analysis. I know I've talked about it before on the show,
right,
but I think it's pretty obvious at this point. I think Notre Dame's going to have trouble running in this game, and that's going to put a lot of pressure on the quarterback. It was fine against a team like a Florida State or Toledo or a Purdue,
mm-hmm,
but Wisconsin's a top five defense. And I'm just not convinced Notre Dame can pull off this specific matchup, can get the better of that Wisconsin defensive line, knowing how much turmoil there is up front. You got guys playing out of position. You got third string left tackles in there. You know, it seems like it changes from week to week.
Right.
I think that's going to be a problem for Notre Dame. You stop the running game, you get to Jack Coan, it upsets the balance of the whole thing. That said, the X factor here could be Tyler Buchner. It could be Tyler Buchner because he gives them, I think, something they desperately need in this game, and that's mobility at quarterback. Basically, an extra guy that Wisconsin's got to worry about.
Right.
Now, are they going to start Buchner? No, they're not going to start Buchner. Jack Coan's going to be the guy. He's rightfully still the starter. I think he's played pretty well this season. But I think if Brian Kelly's being honest with himself, he knows that they need to use more of Buchner to keep Wisconsin honest. We'll see what happens on that front. They've used him in very limited duty. He's mostly been a runner. He's got far better wheels than I expected. And he is dynamic as a runner.
Okay.
Can they bring him in and get more out of the passing game with him in there? To what extent they want to use him in that capacity, I just don't know. But I do think that is something that could benefit Notre Dame. I think Wisconsin wins the game because of that very specific mismatch in the trenches. I think that will be enough to propel them over the top. I just don't know if I'm comfortable saying that they cover a 5.5 point spread at this point, because I am not sold in this offense, especially getting separation against a good team. Like,
mm-hmm.
No, No, I haven't seen anything to suggest that they're going to be able to do that. There just aren't many guys on Wisconsin's offense that truly scare me. So I see something like a 4-point win. I told you yesterday when we chatted about this, I think it's like 21-17 Wisconsin. I think they win. I think the defense is able to stifle what Notre Dame wants to do in the running game. It just upsets the balance of the whole offense. I do think we'll see more of Tyler Buchner. I don't know if it matters, but Wisconsin wins but does not cover is my final play.
I don't get that pick at all. I like Notre Dame here. I think there's...
Really?
Yeah.
To win?
Yeah, to win the game. Okay, ooh, few things, man, about Notre Dame. Both of these teams have been bad in the red zone, right? Notre Dame has been just wacky and mistake prone in the red zone, unable to finish drives. Wisconsin, we saw, especially in that first half against Penn State, having issues. I think both teams will improve there. Wisconsin played their best opponent in week one, which you can understand mistakes. You can understand uneven, inconsistent play. Notre Dame, the better part of me, the more optimistic part of me wants to believe that they haven't want to show anything against Purdue and Toledo in preparation for this game, that things are going to be a little bit more open in this game. I like Notre Dame's defense. I don't love Notre Dame's defense. I like the back end especially, right? Kyle Hamilton is a gravitational player that has to be accounted for at all times. But I like Notre Dame's defense enough to the point where I'm more comfortable with their combination of quarterback and defense because, I don't know, what is your big Graham Mertz performance ever?
No, I know. I mean, it might be week one of last
year.
Right,
that doesn't mean anything. So
yeah.
I think Jack Coan, and to whatever extent maybe they use Tyler Buchner situationally, are in a better place. Notre Dame has two running backs, and Ches Malusi's fine so far. We'll see. Notre Dame has two running backs who can affect things and generate bigger plays. They have probably the best offensive weapon in this game in Michael Mayer, right? Yes? Most dependable offensive skill player. And they've had a receiver step up in Avery Davis. That's who is the guy stepping up, yes? He has emerged as
Avery
like
Davis, the... Kevin Austin, if Jack Coan can throw the ball anywhere near his catch radius, I think Kevin Austin is in line for... They have guys, right? They have guys, but it just doesn't seem like they're fully in sync yet. And that was a huge question going into the season. Who's going to catch passes outside of Michael Mayer? You've had different guys step up at different points so far this season, but... ultimately getting on the same page with Jack Coan, the sooner that happens, the better for this offense.
Yeah. I don't know. I think Notre Dame's going to be, even with a new defensive coordinator, I guess I would like Notre Dame more if Clark Lee was still there and Jeremiah, I forget. I've never been good with his name.
Owusu Koramoah.
Thank you. If he was still there. I'm going to go with Notre Dame protecting themselves these last couple weeks and doing a poor job of it, obviously. And I think they show more on offense. I think they're going to step up. Brian Kelly has been better against ranked teams. Save your laughs. I know the playoff results. Better against ranked teams in these spots than Paul Chryst has been against the spread these last few years. So I think Notre Dame's just a better team. This was a playoff team last year. And I'm not a believer in Wisconsin's offense. Sorry.
One thing, and this is the final note.
Yeah.
I'm very curious to see. And we heard a lot about it in the preseason and everyone kind of furrowed their brow. Like, how's he going to pull this one off? But I do think this is a game where we could see a lot of both Chryst Tyree and Kyren Williams in the backfield at the same time.
Great.
I think quick passes, swing passes, stuff like that to get those guys in space. That's one way. There are multiple ways, right? You can put a guy in a slot. Chryst Tyree could play in the slot and take a screen pass, that sort of thing. But I think some of those quick passes to get the ball out of Jack Coan's hands, you're going to see more of that, if only out of necessity.
Mm-hmm.
They're just going to have to, because the Lion, I do not think, can hold back Wisconsin. I got 21-17. What's your final?
I have 24-20 Notre Dame.
Wow. Okay. Well, we agree on the margin, but disagree on the result.
Yep. Hey, thanks for watching. Consider, if you haven't, subscribing to the channel and hitting that little bell to be alerted and listening to the podcast at solidverbal.com.